Yes, you guys, welcome back. And welcome to the player ratings video after our 3-0 win against Watford earlier tonight. Now, I'm still happy. I'm still in a good mood. This was the perfect response after that disappointing loss against West Ham. I can guarantee that Frank Lampard was ecstatic, was happy. Great performance. We dominated from the first minute to the last minute. And most importantly, we picked up a clean sheet and we looked good from set pieces. We have so much potential in this team. We have so much great young talent. Things are really starting to come together now, you guys. And before I actually get straight into the player ratings video, of course, show your support, smash that like button, help me get over 2,500 likes for today's video, and press the bell notification button if you have not. There is going to be non-stop content coming out for me every single day. So if you guys want to stay up to date to all things from this beautiful club, then I recommend that you guys press that bell notification button. We start with the first player, and that's going to be Kepa Arrizabalaga. Now, this was the perfect game for Kepa. He was barely tested throughout the entire game. Watford had no balls, no cojones, and in that sense, this is the game that Kepa really needed after his mare against West Ham. Now, you know, the few things he had to deal with, at least he looks confident, at least he looked comfortable. I don't remember him kicking any balls out of play, so that's a positive first step. For his player score, I'm going to score Kepa a 7 out of 10. We now move on to Reece James, and you know, I do want to maybe speak about him briefly. I've seen a lot on social media that people are disappointed with the impact that Reece has had since the restarts come. Now, one thing I want us to understand is the tactical nature, which is reducing the effectiveness of Reece James. Now, it is quite simple. We're a team that mainly focuses our attacks down that right-hand side, and of course, if you're an opposition team, a Premier League team, where you have your scouts and your analysts looking for weaknesses against us, it's only natural now that teams are starting to find countermeasures to limit the effectiveness of Reece James. Now, this is why Reece James is the perfect modern-day fullback and why he could be one of our best right-backs for this club. I genuinely mean that. Reece couldn't get forward as much as he wanted to because those channels were getting blocked off. But he has different solutions in his arsenal. He made tons of infield runs, allowing Willian to be that last man out wide, allowing Willian to be that last player out wide. And with Willian moving wide, this brought a Watford player alongside him, creating space in the channels. And this is why we saw Reece James really looking like a midfield player at times and playing some nice crosses from dangerous areas from that right-hand side channel. So for me, this was another good performance, a professional performance, an accomplished performance. I'm going to score Reece James a 7 out of 10. We now move on to Christensen. And other than maybe one moment near the end of the game, and at times, maybe Christensen's concentration levels can dip a tiny bit. I could be sounding completely harshly, guys. I thought personally that was amazing skill from Danny Welbeck. Sometimes you just have to give credit. This is the Premier League for a reason. Players are playing at this level for a reason. Moments like this can happen. But in general, Christensen kept the tempo going very well. I liked how he was confident to step into midfield. And for me, that's when Christensen is at his best. When he can do those types of things, when he can bring the play forward. He moved the ball very well, and today I'm going to score Christensen a 7 out of 10. We now move on to Christensen's defensive partner, and that's Kingsley Coman-Zuma. Now, when I tell you that Zuma had Joey Deeney in his back pocket, his side pocket, his front pocket, any pocket, he completely dominated Joey Deeney, and this was beautiful to see. I was happy to see him just cause that foul against Deeney because it's nice to see a Chelsea defender having that power, having that physicality to absolutely dominate a physical strong striker like this. You know, Zuma won 75% of his aerial duels, completely taking out any attacking threat that Watford were hoping to build from Joey Deeney. And for me, this is why we need to see Zuma in this team. Most times we pick up clean sheets, Zuma is playing in those games, and it's for a reason. He is our best pure defender at this club, and I think he highlights today that he can move the ball, and he can move it quite quickly and quite sharp. He played over 100 passes today, having a very good pass completion rate. Kurt Zuma came in big. He needs to play more games, and I'm going to score him an 8 out of 10. And to end things with a back four, we move on to Azpilicueta, and as I've been telling you guys, I wanted to see Aspi playing as a left back today. Not only did playing left back give Pulisic that license to bomb forward and attack more, he also was very good on the ball, provided something in the final third, picking up another assist in the game today. And some of his counter-pressing to his proactive defensive style was what we needed to nullify even more Watford counter-attacks. Very good performance. He's been another player that's really stepped up big since the restart's come. Aspi is going to score a 7.5 out of 10. We now move on to our midfield three, starting with N'Golo Kante sitting behind our 2.8s. And again, this is a typical Kante performance. He doesn't do anything bad in games. And what I love about him playing as our CDM is that now when we play against these teams that just want to park the bus and defend deep, we have an extra player in the final third because Kante has the ability and the confidence to move the ball and carry it into those positions. And when we score the first goal, that came from Kante carrying the ball, speeding the tempo of our attack. And naturally, the move just evolved from that point on, and we eventually scored a goal. He gave us a counter-pressing presence, and he was constantly moving that ball very fast too. He worked alongside Ross Barkley quite well in the build-up phase as well. Kante has made this team much better. I think it's just a straight fact at this point, and I'm going to score him a 7 out of 10. We now move on to Ross Barkley, and today, Ross Barkley got an assist and he scored a goal. This was a good game, and it's quite funny because Barkley is the only guy that can score a goal and get an assist in the same game, and I'm still going to feel like I want to see a bit more from him. I think for me, it's his measured style of play. He prefers to keep things very safe, and most times he tried to attempt a more audacious pass, it didn't always come through. Thank God in that moment for the first goal, he played a nice reverse pass to Giroud, and in general, you know, his involvement in our build-up phase was very important. He was coming deep alongside Kante to be that guy to help us get the ball behind Watford's midfield lines, and in general, his overall game was good. As I said, I still feel like I could see even more from him. I'd like him to be more confident when it comes to expressing himself creatively, but today, he came through, he did what he had to do. I'm going to score Ross Barkley a 7.5 out of 10. We now move on to Mason Mount, and Mason Mount is, you know, slowly looking like the De Bruyne of the team. Now, I know when I mention points like this, I get taken out of context all the time. When I compare the two, it's a comparison. Not a comparison of ability, but a comparison of style. You know, when Mason plays in our midfield, he's not picking up as many touches of the ball as your Barkley's or Kante's. He looks to find space between the midfield lines. You know, he looks to play those quick, sharp passes between the lines to speed up our tempo, create the attacks, and get the ball behind those midfield lines. You know, these are the things you want to see. And he's expressing himself and showing that, yes, he does have that creativity. Playing this role allows him to cover so much distance, find many effective attacking positions too, and since the restart, he's another guy that's really helped improve our midfield and add more attacking threat. Now, he's not going to score as high due to fumbling a few counter-attacks alongside Pulisic near the end. I'm going to score Mason Mount a 7.5 out of 10. This now brings us forward to our front three, starting with Christian Pulisic down the left wing. Now, Pulisic has stepped up, you guys. Pulisic is playing on a different level, you guys. He is looking big. He's looking good. He was taking that game constantly from the first minute to the last minute against Watford. And, you know, the havoc he's creating for us. Winning another penalty. He could have won two penalties in the same game today. Winning so many crucial free kicks. Honestly, these are the things I've been wanting to see. And I knew I'd see it from Pulisic because he's a great player that has great attributes. And he's young. He's got plenty of time on his side, especially working alongside Frank Lampard to maximize this game and become a super effective attacking player. You can just envision him getting better and better. We can see his willingness to attack the spaces inside the box and find good positions there too. It's been a very good first season for him. I'm going to score Pulisic a 7.5 out of 10. We now move on to Willian down our right-hand side. And Willian, the definition of consistency. Mr. Reliable, and I might sound controversial, but I honestly believe that he has a very fair shout at being nominated for our Player of the Year. And I'm talking about just overall consistent performances throughout the entire season. I don't think Willian's played many games under a 7 out of 10, if I'm keeping things very real, and that's because he provides so much for us in the build-up phase, especially down that right-hand side where it's crucial that we can, you know, open the teams up, open that space up, and break these teams down. Playing against defensive low block teams is so hard, it can make the game quite boring at times too. So this is why Willian's season has been even more impressive. You know, no matter what type of game we're playing against, he is Mr. Reliable, Mr. Consistent. I'm going to score Willian a 7.5 out of 10. And to end things with the first team, we move on to Olivier Giroud. He justified his starting spot, he got a nice goal, a very sexy, classy reverse finish to the bottom right corner, and you know, he makes that trademark run down the left side, that diagonal run down the left, time and time again to great effect. He gets his shots off nice and early. You know, very good striker, and as I constantly say, He's been the one player that's really made me just eat my words and take everything I've said back against him. A great signing, costs us absolutely nothing, but he always comes through when you need him. I'm going to score Olivier Giroud a 7.5 out of 10. This now takes us to the substitutes, starting with Loftus-Cheek, and I'm going to score him a 7 out of 10. I liked his involvement. Slowly, very slowly, he is getting sharper and sharper. Now, with Ruben, you can still see that the way he thinks, the way he sees football, is still there. He was quite unlucky with his headed effort on goal. He timed his run well. He made that late arrival inside the box that sometimes we do miss at times, and it was very unfortunate not to score. However, his involvement was very telling near the end of the game, where it was his nice little bit of composure to just keep the ball in that tight area to find the best suitable pass to make that effectively created that goal for the third goal. So it was a nice involvement. He's slowly getting there. I'm going to score Loftus-Cheek a 7 out of 10. We now move on to Hudson-Odoi, and it was very good to see this guy back. And you can imagine that Hudson-Odoi could not wait to get back on this field. Now, we have to accept that, yes, he's naturally going to be a bit rusty. He hasn't played for a long time. His first game back for a while, and I thought he kept the ball quite tidy at times, you know, some very safe and tidy passes, and at times he was trying to get past his man, but during those moments you could see his rustiness because he's only just come back. I'm going to score Callum a 6 out of 10, and this takes us on to Billy Gilmour and Tammy Abraham. Both players are going to score a 6 out of 10. In the case of Billy Gilmour, yes, he got caught out again in midfield. He is young. I think in particular, since the restart's come, he needs to get used to that tempo again. The more minutes he gets, more game time, these are things that will come out of his game eventually. He's still very young. It does happen. And what I like is that Billy reacts very well. So he deserves a 6. And in the case of Tammy Abraham, he was unfortunate again because the tempo of the game was just not the same. You know, we weren't creating as much. We were playing balls quite safe at times too. Games happen like this sometimes, but it was nice to see his work rate and his willingness for the cause. So he gets a 6 out of 10. And to end things with super Frankie Lampard, I'm going to score him a 9 out of 10. He got the lineup on point. Excellent lineup that gave us an advantage from the first minute of this game right to the last. His game management is on point too. Lampard is showing signs of tactical eliteness. There's so many things he's doing right, from signing, some squad management, to the tactical role and the tactical setup too, to his game management skills as well, and his ability to know how to turn a game round into our favour. He's still very young. He's only going to get better as the years go on. I'm going to score Frank Lampard a 9 out of 10. And there you have you guys. They were my player ratings after our 3-0 win against Watford. In the comments below, give me your player ratings. Who stood out for you? Who was the best player? What moments of the game really inspired you? And what really stood out for you? Let me know below. I'm EFC. This is Blue Lions TV. I'll catch you guys later with some more videos.